This is an educational purpose video, such as resonant frequency calculation, produce carrier wave and sound wave electric pulse. FM transmitter is a fun project, and this is an attracting device for child. Need a long range FM transmitter? Then you just have to follow some rules. Actually, how it's working? What mystery is hidden behind it? Let's find out. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. If you want to make professional PCB, then go to JLC PCB website. You can make here 2, 3, 4 and more layer PCB. Even you can choose your PCB's board thickness. In the other hand, you can choose different type of colored PCBs, but of absolutely free of cost. I make a FM transmitter PCB design and make sure that it is okay. Then export this PCB as a Gerber file and upload this PCB on JLC PCB website within only $2. After 7 days, I got this PCB from JLC PCB. In this box, you can find nice packing 10 PCB only in $2. See these PCBs, these are awesome in quality. Without any doubt, you can order it yourself. For more information, visit their website. Let's see a basic process to make a FM transmitter. In this basic, you will understand this more better. FM transmitter are divided into two parts. First one is amplitude audio frequency and second will produce carrier frequency. Every sound frequency is like electrical pulse. When sound rise up, that means electrical pulse will amplitude, or you can call it electrical wave. Let me show you a demo. See, I put a audio jack in my laptop and other end to my baby oscilloscope and play some music, and you can see the electrical pulse. I know the graph is very messy. When we play any song, there are so many different type of frequency which look like messy. So I think you guys having too difficult to understand this. Okay, let's see another way to clear this. Now I play some 50Hz tone, and here you can see the 50Hz beautiful sine wave. If I slowly increase volume, then the signal will slowly amplitude. Condenser microphone work in the same way with audio pulse. Okay, now let's see how to produce resonant frequency. If I attached a ceramic capacitor with an inductor and put in some volt, then this circuit produces some resonant frequency. This type of circuit called tank circuit. But here is some problem. This circuit can produce frequency a little amount of time, because in this case we face a maximum power drop. Okay, no problem. See, when this circuit power up, it make this type of resonant frequency. At first time, this frequency are amplitude and slowly goes down to zero. We need to some component that can produce constant amplitude resonant frequency. That's why you need a transistor that can make an amplitude frequency. This circuit needs some resistor to active the transistor. And for stable frequency, you need some kind of ceramic capacitor. Here this capacitor works as an inductor feedback, and then it will produce constant resonant frequency. Which frequency you need to transmit on your FM radio, that's why you need to put this formula. Frequency is equal to 1 divided by 2 into pi into root over inductance in capacitance. Now if I talk about this formula, then this video become more long. In this basis, I make an inductor 4mm by 5mm. And take all component those we are needed for make this FM transmitter. First I put here 3.5 mm socket for transmission external audio source. On the other hand, I put two tiny switch, one for the on off and another one is mic and external audio. Here you need some ceramic capacitor for feedback process, produce resonant frequency, volt filter and antenna filter. Also you need a trimming capacitor, this is optional. Leave. If you don't wanna use it, not a problem. This capacitor is only for produce different megahertz transmission. And I put inductor that already I made. Even I put some resistor for transistor oscillate and stop unwanted wave. And don't forget to put electrolytic capacitor for a smooth sound wave. For voice transmitting, I put here condenser mic. And also put a LED for see puffer power up signal. At the end, I use here SL1005 transistor. This is high gain transistor. I use this transistor for better FM transmitting and long range, and put a female header for power connection. After completing all hard work, now time to check how it will work. Now time for the phone, and connect the external speaker with this phone to produce loudspeaker. I open radio application on my phone. Beside, I connect 9 volt battery with this FM transmitter. and turn on FM transmitted power switch, and the LED indicates that it is on. Two ways to connect this device. First way, you can search the transmitting frequency on your phone or something else device. And second way to connect by trimming this capacitor. Okay, now this is connected. If I switch to mic mode, then I hope you can hear this. Hello, hello.
How are you? Welcome to Tdiscover.
And also you can switch external audio source as a laptop, cell phone or something like that. I hope it can transmit good quality audio. What you would say? Tell me your opinion in comment section. I hope you can learn something new. If you want to watch more video like this, then you can subscribe my channel to stay updated.